Good morning or good afternoon, depending on the time. My name is Rui Simões. I'm professor in Civil Engineering Department at the University of Coimbra, and I'm going to present a research work developed in the scope of a national research project involving the University of Coimbra and an industrial partner. The aim of the research was to study and design a reinforcing system in order to increase the loading capacity of steel concrete composite slabs. The research has included experimental and numerical studies, but in this presentation, I will only address the experimental part. I will start with an introduction, then the description of the proposed reinforcing system, the experimental campaign carried out, which comprises small-scale tests and full-scale tests on simple and continuous composite slabs in order to calibrate a design methodology and to prove the efficiency of the reinforcing system, and some final remarks. Steel concrete composite slabs are structural members widely used in the execution of floors in multi-story buildings. They are composed of cold-formed profile steel sheets, which works as formwork during the construction phase, supporting the layer of wet concrete and as the tensile reinforcement after the concrete hardening. The main advantages are absence of conventional formwork, reduction of propping needs, reduction of tensile reinforcements. The sheets are of ease handling, storage, and transportation, and these structural members are characterized by high speed of construction. In terms of design, being a composite member, both construction and definitive phases must be taken into account on safety and service verifications. For the definitive phase, the collapse modes that must be taken into account in the design for the ultimate limit states are bending close to the midspan, longitudinal shear along the shear span, vertical shear close to the supports, and punching shear if relevant point loads exist. This graph represents the relation between the resistance introduced by the reaction at the end supports of the slab VT and the slab span introduced by the shear span LS equal to one quarter of the total span in the case of a simple supported slab submitted to a uniform distributed load. The first three collapse modes are represented by the three lines, green, blue, and red. In composite slabs with common spans, I may say between 2 and 5 meters, the longitudinal shear failure tends to be the governing design mode, which does not allow the development of the full bending capacity of the slabs. This was the main reason that led us to propose the reinforcing system, developed and designed aiming to increase the longitudinal shear resistance of composite slabs that I will now present. The system is composed by a set of transversal reinforcing bars distributed along the span, placed in vertical cuts executed in the longitudinal stiffeners with an inverted V shape, located at the upper flanges of the profile steel sheeting. As the transversal bars are embedded in the concrete layer, the longitudinal shear resistance is obtained through the bearing effect between the bars and the steel sheet developed in the crossing points. Well, although the system will involve an increase on sheet production costs and on-site works, we identify the following main advantages. It increases the load-bearing capacity, it increases the ductility, it is possible the combination with the shear resistance system provided by the embossments, its efficiency is independent of the geometry and of the material of the supporting beams, easy to incorporate in design methods, and welding works are avoided. The system can be designed in several variants. It can be a simple reinforcing system placing the transversal bars on the vertical cuts, or it can be combined with the longitudinal bars on the ribs to form a reinforcing mesh. To study the efficiency of the proposed reinforcing system, two new profiles were developed by the industrial partner of the project, LAMI 60+ with 60 millimeters height, and Lamy 120 plus with 120 millimeter size. Both profiles based on standard already existing profiles H60 and H120. The surface of the profiles sheets used and produced for this research was smooth without embossments due to the fabrication process limitations. And as a consequence, in the tests carried out, after the loss of the friction interlock between steel and concrete, the longitudinal shear resistance depends completely of the mechanical interlock provided by the transversal parts crossing the steel sheet. According to the personal connection method, the longitudinal shear verification is accounted directly in the bending resistance MRD given by the indicated equation, where NC is the compressive force in the concrete layer. This force NC depends on the longitudinal shear stress resistance, tau URD, that can be developed between the two materials depending of the embossments. As in our study, smooth sheets were used, this shear stress is defined by analogy, dividing the concentrated bearing resistance provided on the contact points by the influence area. And the resistance at each contact point was obtained through a set of standard push tests, as the one represented on the left, and the equation to predict this resistance was obtained using a statistical analysis in accordance with the Annex D of standard EN 1990. In this slide, in the table contains the six full-scale tests carried out, four in simple supported slabs, group A, and two in two-span slabs, group B. On figures on the right, we can see the layouts used for both groups. On group A, smooth sheets were used with different heights, 150 and 200 millimeters, but with same amount of transversal rebars, bars of 8 millimeters in diameter, spacing 200 millimeters. In the last one, test day four, an additional longitudinal bar of 12 millimeters in diameter was used in the ribs. On the group B, two slabs were tested for comparison, one using a conventional sheet with embossments and another using a smooth sheet with the proposed reinforcing system. But in here, we have the main results. All specimens of group A have collapsed by longitudinal shear to bearing on crossing points, but for load levels very close to the bending moment resistance of the transversal cross sections of the slabs, as proven by the crack pattern verified along the span. From the analysis of the curves, load, vertical displacement, and load and slip, we may conclude that the slabs with the proposed reinforcing system present high bending capacity, high ductility, and reduced end slips. If we compare the maximum loads reached in the tests carried out and the predicted load capacities of the corresponding conventional slabs, only with embossments, last column of the table, we verify load increases between 35% to 70%. The table on the right contains the ratio between the max bending moments reached on the tests and the bending moment resistance MRD of the slabs evaluated by the partial connection method of the Rokov 4. Well, the values above one mean a conservative prediction. In this slide, we have an overview of test layout used in both tests of group B, B1 using a conventional sheet just with embossments, and B2 using a smooth sheet with the proposed reinforcing system. But both collapse by longitudinal shear failure. However, while the conventional slab B1 collapsed in a brittle mode, the slab with the proposed reinforcing system collapsed for a higher load, 43% higher, and in a ductile mode, as we can see in the graph. As the reinforcing system depends essentially on the bearing resistance of the steel sheet on contact points, the sheet thickness and the steel grade are the most relevant parameters for the efficiency of the system. So just to evaluate the influence of steel sheet thickness, let's to consider the following example. Two composite slabs are considered with the same height of 200 millimeters and same materials S 320 on steel and concrete C2530. But the first is a conventional slab with a steel sheet with embossments, and the second is an equivalent composite slab, but with the reinforcing system, in this case composed by transversal bars of 8 millimeters in diameter, spaced 250 millimeters. The graphs on the right represent the loading capacity in kilonewton per square meter as a function of the span in meters for three different steel sheet thickness, 0.7, 1 and 1.5 millimeter for both typologies. And for example, if we consider a conventional slab with steel sheet just with embossments for a common span of 4 meters, the increase on the loading capacity, changing the thickness from 0.7 millimeters to 1.5 millimeters, is of about 39%. But for the composite slab with same steel sheet, but with the proposed reinforcing system, for the same span of 4 meters, the increase on the load capacity is much higher, is of about 196% higher. As final remarks, we may state that the proposed reinforcing systems allow to achieve the full bending capacity and increase the ductility of composite slabs. The behavior of the slab is no longer dependent on the anchorage devices. The resistance of the composite slabs with the proposed reinforcing system can be predicted by the partial connection method of the Rockwood 4. The efficiency of the reinforcing system tends to be more effective in composite slabs with profile steel sheeting with higher values of thickness and higher steel grades. Transversal reinforcement bar could be combined with embossments on profile steel sheeting, although this combined effect still needs to be confirmed through additional studies. Finally, the authors would like to thank the Portuguese Foundation for Science and Technology for its support, and thank you very much for your attention.